I remember growing up and hearing this term that really seemed like a badge of honor at the time. He or she, or it was mainly he is a jack of all trades. And if it was a woman, she's a Jill of all trades, right? And so people kind of prided themselves on being the jack or Jill of all trades. And then even in my career, my early career as a performer, I even wrote a song called Jack of All Trades. And it was about, being a jack of all trades and a master of a few. That was the actual chorus line. Jack of all trades and a master of a few. And most of us have grown up thinking that that's the way to be. Nowadays, they don't use the term of being a jack of all trades. We just hustle and we do so many things. But I just want to say to you, after, over 20 plus years of working with entrepreneurs, coaching, consulting, and advising, and then of course my interviews with Black millionaires, I begin to understand that that's not quite, that's not necessarily a good thing to be a jack of all trades, because it kind of leads you to not being a master of anything, and it only leads you to mediocre results because you're doing everything right. So today's language, everybody's hustling and you're doing a whole bunch of things, but then we're wondering why our businesses are stagnant and don't grow. And it's because we're still trying to be the jack of all trades. I have to know everything. And I submit to you that that's the wrong way to build a business, especially if you want tremendous success. You want to focus on your strengths and you want to master your strengths. So remember that line, jack of all trades, master of a few. No, I want you to master your strength. Focus on your strength. What is your God-given talent, your God-given strength that you have an unfair competitive advantage with? That would allow you to go into the marketplace and not be good, but be great, be phenomenal, be excellent. And that requires some pulling back, right? Because sometimes you can fall in love with being the jack of all trades, but you're really falling short of becoming a master at what you're good at. And then once you're mastering what you're good at, you allow others, you begin to develop relationships or partnerships or collaborations or build teams of people who are masters at what they're good at. And then you work with them. And then now you have this phenomenal success, this phenomenal thrust behind you with what it is that you want to do. But as long as you continue to allow others to not work with you, you don't build teams of people who are focusing and operating in their unique gifts, their unique talents, their strengths, you'll always fall short of hitting probably the goal that you really want to hit. We all want major success, but we're wondering why we're stuck and we're not getting it. And I'm telling you, this is key. Out of the hundreds of entrepreneurs that I've talked to, you find people doing mediocre things, participating in activities that they're mediocre in. And again, I'm the jack of all trades, but I tell you, forget about being a jack of all trades. Master your strength. Focus on your strength and then master your strengths. Talk soon.